How long does your visa have to remain stuck in administrative processing before you can consider filing a mandamus lawsuit to resolve that visa? I'm Josh Goldstein. I'm an immigration lawyer based in Los Angeles, and I help people and families across the country and around the world get their visas out of administrative processing. The question comes up often in consultations. How long do you have to be stuck in administrative processing? Is there a certain period of time that you have to wait in administrative processing before you can file the lawsuit? Maybe one day in administrative processing is not enough. But what about 6 months? I heard you have to wait a year in administrative processing before you can file a mandamus lawsuit. These are the questions that come up time and time again in consultations, and I'd like to explore with you how I think about these things. First of all, the gist of a mandamus lawsuit is the solution for what you need to do if you're stuck in administrative processing. I file a mandamus lawsuit, I sue the consulates, and then the visa is issued. And the gist of the lawsuit is that there has been an unreasonable delay. Now, we have to convince a judge that the delay has been unreasonable. Well, what's an unreasonable delay? Isn't that subjective? What's unreasonable to one person might not be unreasonable to another person. How do you define unreasonable? It's difficult to say, but I'll let you know how I think about this. And this is my professional opinion. It's not really based on any kind of a case law or anything like that. But this is just the way that I analyze cases as someone who files these lawsuits all the time. First of all, the amount of time in administrative processing is not, to me, what's relevant. To me, the key issue is how long has the entire process taken? And I measure that from the beginning of when someone filed a visa petition. For example, in an I-130 marriage-based type case, when did you file that I-130? In other words, if the I-130 was just filed 6 months ago, and then now you're stuck in administrative processing, I think it's very difficult to make the argument that there's been an unreasonable delay if there's only been less than a year has passed. On the other hand, if you filed the I-130 3 years ago and it's been in administrative processing for a month, I would argue that even without administrative processing, the delay has already been unreasonable, and then you could bring suit. So for me, I really look at the entire length of time that the process has taken. I also put no stock at all in the government's published processing times. Sometimes you go online and it'll say, for example, a particular type of application is taking between 17.5 and 48.5 months. I don't pay attention to that. Just because the government says that's how long it's taking them to process something doesn't mean that's reasonable. I mean, if they told you it was going to take 7 years to process an application, you can't just assume that what the government says is reasonable. What's reasonable is what a judge thinks is reasonable. So in my opinion, what I'm looking for in terms of the length of time, what I'm looking for is I'm looking for a case that's been pending for more than a year. In other words, from the beginning of the case, from the filing of the visa petition or whatever the first act was, until the time now, how long has that taken? Has it been at least 1 year? If it hasn't been at least 1 year, then I recommend that you'd hold off on considering mandamus. If it's been more than 1 year, then I think it's ripe and ready for mandamus. And sometimes, the truth is, sometimes by the time people come to me, they've been waiting for years for their visas, and their visas have been stuck. And it's incredibly heartbreaking and frustrating to see. But the good news is there is a solution. The mandamus cases that I file are extremely effective. So if your visa, for the entire time, processing time for your case, has been more than 1 year, you should consider mandamus, and I'd be happy to talk with you about that and answer all your questions. Just reach out to me or leave a comment below, and I will be in touch. Thank you so much, and we'll see you in the next video.